Hey guys, how's everyone doing? I'm AnimeIntensity and welcome back to my channel. Today we're actually going to have an anime review, which I haven't done in a while, so this is so very exciting. I hope to get back into my anime reviews as well, so yeah, more anime watching to do. So today we're going to be discussing a little short series, which I really mean short. It's called She and Her Cat, Everything Flows. It's by Linden Films, and it was based on a short by Makoto Shinkai way back in the day, a couple of years back. So for those of you who aren't familiar with Makoto Shinkai, he's directed things like Voices of the Distant Star and The Garden of Words. He is a very talented director. Everything that he directs is so visually stunning. And I'm like always in awe watching his stuff because it's like, it's gorgeous. I mean, it's absolutely gorgeous. So She and Her Cat, Everything Flows is based on that little short that he made, you know, few years back, and it's actually very, very short. Only 4 episodes, and they're only about 7 minutes and 45 seconds each, but with the credits, it's only about like 5 minutes. So they're only 5-minute episodes, and there are only 4 of them, so you could easily finish, you know, this little short series in like 20 minutes. Not that bad at all, I have to say. Not that bad. So for the longest time, Miu and her cat Daru have been inseparable. She is a college student and she's living with her best friend, and one day her best friend has to go. She's like, oh, sorry, I have to go with my man. She ends up having to pay for the apartment herself, so she has to find a job herself, and she's with her cat Daru, so she's not totally alone, but we see the bond between pet and human, and that's really what the gist of She and Her Cat, Everything Flows is really about, you know, the bond between a cat and the owner, you know. So very, very simple, but it accomplished so much for such a short amount of time. One of the first things that you will notice when you watch She and Her Cat, Everything Flows is that there's a lot of personification going on. I mean, our main character is a cat, a big fluffy black cat, and everything is told from his point of view, which is so interesting to see because usually we see, you know, stories like this told in the human's point of view, but this time we are seeing everything in the cat's point of view, and it's so, so interesting to watch and so sweet and so sad sometimes, but it's so cute. And the thing is that, you know, we see how Daru really loves his owner. He's always like, oh, I love the way she smells, I love the way she smiles, and I wait here all day until she comes back home or whatever, and it kind of breaks your heart, but you love it so much. It's bittersweet because you really see the bond between Daru and Miu, the bond between a cat and a human, and it's just so, so sweet. Another thing that you're gonna notice about She and Her Cat, Everything Flows is how realistic and how human it is. I mean, yes, this anime really revolves around a cat, you know, telling you his thoughts and whatever, but everything else feels so, so realistic, from the details that we see, you know, when Miu like makes breakfast or lays in bed or whatever. Everything just feels so real, so human, and I absolutely love that when an animation crew can capture the movements, you know, like such realistic movements that you feel like you're watching an actual human being, and I absolutely love that. I thought it was just very, very lovely to see, and just something that makes She and Her Cat so special. The attention to details, absolutely amazing. And also the designs in this anime aren't too dramatic or exaggerating. You know, people look like people, the cat looks like a cat, and everything looks very, very realistic, and I absolutely love things like that because it doesn't go out of its way to make it seem like, oh, this is super unreal or anything. She and Her Cat really tries to make itself as relatable as it possibly can, and that's what makes it so strong. The emotions that we feel also as well for Miu and her sadness and her depression feel like they're going through the TV and you're feeling it too. It's absolutely amazing how they managed to pack such human emotions into this anime that's so, so short. So something else that I really enjoyed about that. I think one of the best things about She and Her Cat, Everything Flows has to be how much it accomplishes in such a short amount of time. Absolutely wow. I mean, there are often series that are meant to be emotional and meant to get you attached to the characters, and I don't feel anything. I don't know if it's because I'm heartless. Maybe I'm heartless, but you know, I feel like She and Her Cat accomplished so much in just a short amount of time, and that is absolutely amazing. I mean, for an anime that you can complete in about 20 minutes, you get so attached to our main characters. You get attached to Miyu and her sadness and her depression, and you want to know more about her and how she's going to get out of the whole situation. And we also get attached to Daru, who also has like this human-like personality that we see. I love the personification in this anime. Watching she and her cat, you really feel like this is what goes on inside an animal's head. This is what they think about. I don't know if that's what they really think about, but just imagine, it just breaks your heart. It really goes to show you the bond between a pet and a human. And I don't have a cat because I'm allergic. I'm like really, really allergic, so I have a dog. And she gives me allergies too, but that's not the point. She and her cat just really shows us that there are bonds between pets and humans. And it's just so, so beautiful and so well done. I absolutely loved seeing that bond between those two. Just so, so nice. And I usually don't get emotional when I watch my anime, but I felt like I was tearing. I was like, by the end of the anime, I felt like a tear. The only thing that I didn't really like about this anime is that it's short. And that's not really a huge complaint, but I would have loved more of this. I mean, it's just so enjoyable to watch. And, you know, just seeing that so much was done in 20 minutes, maybe if there were like 40 minutes in total, like what if there were a couple of more episodes and we had 40 minutes of this series to watch, you know, who knows? I think it would be very, very cool, and you know, I would like to see more of it. Overall, I'm gonna have to give She and Her Cat Everything Flows an 8 out of 10 because it is absolutely heart-wrenching. It is bittersweet, it is happy, it's sad, there's so many emotions going on in such a short series, and I absolutely loved every second of it. So I very, very, like, totally highly recommend it. It's absolutely very emotional, but if you like stories about animals and whatever, you're definitely going to like She and Her Cat Everything Flows. I do recommend bringing your little, you know, your box of tissues. It does get emotional at times, but it's such a rewarding series to watch. I didn't even think that I would enjoy it that much, and after I finished watching the last episode, I was like, what am I gonna do with my life? The amount that it got to accomplish in such a short amount of time. That's why I like anime shorts. Definitely very, very cool. And like I said, if you like to watch it, it's on Crunchyroll, so make sure you check it out. And you have no excuse not to watch it because it's only like 20 minutes in total. So, you know, it's a very short series. You can watch it before you go to school, before you go to work, whatever. And yeah, it's very, very rewarding. So I hope you like this anime review. Please like, share, subscribe if you liked this video. I have more anime reviews coming up soon, and I will see you guys next time. So it turns out that senpai has finally noticed us, and by senpai, I mean the Merriam-Webster Dictionary. Not that they're my senpai, but it finally turns out that the Merriam-Webster Dictionary has recognized the term senpai.